start.
My treat. I have just sent them to a relaxing spa in the middle of nowhere.
Your dad's car, is it safe to drive?
Probably not.
Try it again.
I've tried, we're going nowhere.
Oh, what have you done?
I spiked her drink.
With what?
A drug that induces labour.
Ah, okay, that felt different.
They didn't check into the hotel.
I asked at the desk. No one's seen her. They never arrived. We'll find her.
How? I've got Esther's phone and Sinead hasn't got hers. We've got no clue where they are.
I mean, how long before she goes into labour? What are we talking? What, hours? Minutes? When?
It's possibly already underway.
Oh.
It's your fault, you crank. If anything happens to our baby...
stop!
Look, you go and check Sinead again and we'll go and look in the dog.
Go!
I'm sorry.
Save it. Esther is probably giving birth right now, and we need to find her.
Look, it won't be long, Esther, okay? I promise you.
It's coming, Sinead. I am having this baby now.
Babe, I was in labour for days, okay? Trust me, I know what I'm talking about. Take a little look, shall we?
Sinead! It's coming, isn't it?
I think that's put me off sex for life.
Oh, what are we going to do?
You know, just, like, slow it down a bit. Stupid question.
Oh, I'm scared.
Look, someone will be here any second.
Sinead, we are in the middle of nowhere. What if something goes wrong? I can't do this on my own.
Full stop. I don't want you to breathe. Breathe.
You going home?
Home?
You know what I mean.
You know, I've been thinking... maybe I should tell Dad about what I did to his car. I mean, Sinead and Esther were in there. Anything could have happened to him.
I told you, they'll be fine. So, you know how they've just finished repairing the city walls? Well, it says in the paper that they found a human skull from Roman times. They reckon he was killed by a pickaxe through the head.
If you're trying to cheer me up, it's not going to work.
Maybe your dad will have calmed down a bit.
Yeah, he's probably laughing about it right now. In fact, we're going to go shopping together and he's going to help me pick out a nice little dress and some new heels.
All right, don't take it out on me.
I'm sorry. You know what? I don't give a stuff what he thinks. And messing up his car's just the start.
Oh, I am sorry, Frankie. Have we got a hangover? I would never be having sat up till 3 o'clock this morning drinking with Rini.
She's still upset about Pete.
Oh, hi, what's your excuse? You know, no wonder Tom's hitting the bottle, the way you two are carrying on.
Please, will you just pack it in, Jack?
She quit her job. I should never have had her back. She's a bad influence.
Yeah, well, she's a good barmaid and she brings the business in.
Oh, she's bad for business. She's drinking all my profits and then the loft's reopened. We've got competition again. No, she is going to have to go.
Right, well, then you can tell her.
No, it's better coming from you.
You're not scared of her, are you?
No. Yes.
Tough. You're doing it anyway.
Hey. I just wondered if you'd heard anything from Esther.
She's going to see Sinead. What do you want her for?
We were just going to do something with her this morning.
Bit of a, you know, retail therapy. Don't worry, we'll catch up with her later.
No, hang on a second, I'll give her a ring.
I've got her phone.
Right, what's this really about?
Brazilian.
Well, it's the first thing that popped into my head. Because you're the one that mentioned retail therapy.
Yeah, well, maybe I should just phone the police and report Esther missing.
Grace, I could go to prison.
Yeah, well, you should have thought of that before you drugged a pregnant woman.
Sorry. I'm just a bit worried about her.
But I did this for us, Grace. I just want us to be together.
And I want us to be together too, but we need to find Esther first.
Can't we just wait an hour or something? And if we haven't heard by then...
Yeah, it'll be too late by then. Yeah, police.
I need a doctor. I think I'm doing it wrong. What if I'm doing it wrong?
No, you are doing it fine, OK? Just keep pushing. Push!
I am pushing!
Come on, you're nearly there.
See, I told you it was a problem. You did it. Oh, no one's perfect, babe.
Oh, she is.
Welcome to the world. Sinead, I don't feel too good.
Babe, we need to get you to a hospital.
Is it bad?
No, it's okay.
Tell me the truth.
I just need to go and get you some help.
No.
I've got to.
Sinead, please don't leave.
I am going to be right back. I promise you, okay? Everything's going to be fine.
How are you?
Oh, I can't complain. Well, I can, but no one listens to that.
Mm. Have you seen Rina this morning?
Are you kidding? She's like a vampire. She doesn't surface till the sun goes down.
Now, look, when she does surface, will you tell her I don't need her at the pub anymore?
Oh, hang on, Jack. You're sacking her. How come?
She's late for every shift. She's rude to my customers, and she helps herself to the optics without paying.
Yeah, but, I mean, apart from that...
Marlene, I've had enough of her.
Oh, come on, Jack. This isn't like you. I was only saying to the girls before, he's lovely fella, that Jack. Big-hearted, bit of a silver fox. Oh, if I were 5 years younger. Oh, just give her one more chance. For me, please.
OK, last chance.
She sent me a lovely little text message the other day asking me how I was. She put a little kiss on the end of it.
How old are you? 12? They put kisses on the end of everything these days.
Trust me, there's more to it than that. Ah, speak of the devil. Can we kiss you?
What?
It means cheer up.
Oh, still keeping up with them Chinese lessons then.
I can teach you a few words if you like. What do you do tonight? Do you fancy a drink?
Sure, why not?
That's a date then. It's all tonight.
When he says date...
Did you send him a text with a little kiss on the end?
I don't know. I might have. I felt sorry for him. He doesn't think that...
There's no fool like an old fool.
Funny, dear.
What are you talking about?
You know exactly what I'm talking about. The club. I've been dragged away from looking for Esther to clean up your mess.
You mean she hasn't come home yet?
You know what? I blame your mother. She was too soft on you.
Sorry, I'm such a disappointment.
Yeah. Well, that makes both of us.
You think I'm a little pansy, don't you? Well, come on, then.
I don't hate girls.
Is that what I am?
Man, you're not a man, are you? You're... I don't know what you are. You know, I used to look up to my dad. I used to idolise him. I would have done anything to make him proud, but you! I'm embarrassed to call you my son.
Why wouldn't you open the door?
I'm doing stuff.
What stuff? Is everything all right?
Everything's fine.
What happened to you?
I walked into something.
What, your dad's fist?
Just stay out of it.
I'll put some makeup on it for you.
Get off me.
Dylan.
I'm not a girl. Don't treat me like one. Get out. Get out!
It's gonna be okay, isn't it?
But look, he is gonna be fine. Like, the paramedics have checked him out. Just concentrate yourself.
Please don't leave me.
I won't, I promise.
Stupid old cow.
You should be thanking me. I just saved your job. Jack would have sacked you. You're supposed to be working in the pub, not drinking it dry.
Flipping soaked.
Are you listening to me?
Frankie's worse than me. She's a bad influence.
Oh, but we're not relying on Frankie's wages, are we? You need to get your act together. It's Cleo's prize giving on Thursday. And we promised her a party. Remember?
Yeah, I'll get the money.
See you do, Renee. And I mean it. You've let these kids down once too often.
Don't you come on Mother of the Year with me, all right, because he doesn't wash. You might have everyone round here fooled Nana, but I know what you tried to do. What's the matter? Cat got your tongue? Sorry, Mum, I didn't mean it. I was upset.
I just want you to hold this job down. That's all I'm saying.
She had a hemorrhage, she had to stop the bleeding, postpartum or something.
She's gonna be okay, though.
Yeah. You know, one minute she's fine and the next minute she's in labour.
Yeah, well, I guess it was a good job you were there, Sinead.
Yeah, we all we want.
Right, well, I best get back to my own baby. And listen, missus, the next time you want to stay in a hotel, give someone else a shout, eh? See you later.
How you feeling?
I can't feel a thing, I'm dosed up to the eyeballs.
Can I? Hey.
Hey, little fella.
We are Mummy and Daddy. We have waited so long for this, I never thought it'd actually happen.
Congratulations, Mum.
Jordan, really?
Yeah, over my dead body. Listen, I don't want to alarm you, but we need to take the baby to an incubator now.
Why do you have to take him?
What's wrong with him?
He's a month premature, so he's a little undersized. His lungs aren't fully developed yet, so he's going to be kept in the neonatal unit for the next 4 weeks or so.
No, but he's going to be okay, though, right?
Please try not to worry, okay? He's going to be fine. Till I found you. Somebody to get me my life back. And I don't want to wake up. And to find you just some dream I had. I found you. Somebody to get me my life back. And I don't want to wake up. And to find you just some dream.
Oh, busy, are you?
It takes a bit of work to look this good. Can't wait to get to your age. Don't have to put the effort in, do you?
You cheeky slut.
Just kidding. Put it away last night, didn't we, eh?
You're not kidding.
Excuse me, this is the ladies.
Well, if I see any ladies, I'll let you know.
Oh, very droll. Can see why you married him.
Oh, yeah.
Your shift started 15 minutes ago. I told Marlene I'd give you one last chance and I meant it.
Okay, I'm coming.
And I'll be keeping an eye on the optics.
I better get out there. He's flapping about losing punters to the loft.
Really? Don't you worry. I've got just the thing. I'll get your customers back.
How's the baby?
Bleeds out with his breathing, something to do with his lungs. What's all this?
Fancy to change?
I shouldn't have.
It's okay.
No, no, it's not.
You're right. I was asking for it. From now on, I'm going to be the son you'd like me to be. I want to do what you do, and I'm not afraid to get my hands dirty. I'm going to make you proud, Dad.
Gambit.
Gambit.
Oh, no. The Chinese, they don't clink glasses, they touch them. And the key is to try and keep them touching the whole time. Gambit actually means dry glass.
Gambit.
There you go, you can speak Chinese already. Now, I'll teach you another one. Now, this one is a wedding toast.
Oh.
And it means, wait, may your two hearts be as one. Wonderful, Julia.
Oh, more the merrier. Put it down for a threesome.
Pop quiz, fiver a pop.
Great.
Oh, right. Yeah. Go on, Chess, get your money out.
Frankie, I'm not sure about this.
Well, it seems to be going down well with everyone apart from you.
I've tried pub quizzes before and they always end in tears. Or you, doing sharing karaoke, that also ends in tears and they're usually mine.
Esther's in hospital. She's had a baby boy.
You're kidding?
Yeah, Jack, we've got to be there.
I'm not leaving Rini.
No. There have been complications. Esther's in the hospital. Go. I'll look after this place. Go on. Thanks, Luke. I'll see you later. Good luck. Come on in.
Thank you.
Let's see where I keep the change. Right, come on, people. It's happy hour. 2 for 1 and all shots.
Oh, nice one. Yeah, go on, Jez.
Cheers. All's well that ends well.
What? Esther nearly died. And now my baby is being put in an incubator.
He's gonna be fine. It's just precautionary.
You're an ass. You're supposed to be looking after people, not nearly killing them.
Look, I know what I did was wrong, but I wasn't thinking straight. I was thinking with my blood, not my brain.
What are you doing?
I just can't get my hands off you. At least people can know we're together now. You still want to be together, right?
We can't.
I am tired of you stringing me along.
I'm not.
I saw how you were with the baby and Trevor earlier.
I'm not interested in Trevor. Look, I am stringing him along, all right? You know how I feel about you, Kim. Look, we've waited this long. Surely we can wait a couple more weeks, can't we?
Hey, here she is. What are you trying to do to us?
Seen the baby, yeah?
We've not had a chance. Giving birth in the back of a car. You don't do things by half, do you?
How are you feeling, Mum? You think you had it hard? I've had 5.
Esther, have the doctors said how long they're going to keep you in?
You must be shattered.
Okay. Blondie's song, Call Me, featured in which 1980s movie?
I think it's all about the prostitute.
Midnight Cowboy.
No. What's his face? You know, the handsome one. Richard Gere.
Oh, Pretty Woman.
No, he was the prosy in it.
Oh, it's on the tip of my tongue.
Well, it's too late. We have to come back to it. What was the name of Blondie's second album?
Is there any chance we can have a question that isn't about Blondie?
American Gigolo. Write it down.
OK, everyone. Let's take a 5-minute break.
You watch that and I have powder on my nose.
Listen, Charlie,
don't. No offence. You're my brother and I love you. But you're not going to stay here all night, are you? You're crimping my style.
You're wasting your time. And it's cramping your style.
It's crimping.
Cramping.
Yeah. She kissed me. A couple of weeks ago, it's been a bit awkward since, but she's obviously ready to take it to the next level.
I wouldn't bet on it.
Then why is she here?
She doesn't want to hurt you.
Ah, I see. So you can have a younger woman on your arm, but I can't. Because no attractive woman in their right mind would look at me twice, is that it?
I just don't want to see you make a fool of yourself.
Look, there's an age difference, of course there is, but Sienna and I have a connection. We're soulmates.
I didn't have to say this, but she told me she feels sorry for you.
It's true.
After everything that's happened, and you're still all over her.
What are you talking about?
I saw you holding hands like a couple of teenagers.
I don't like this any more than you do.
Well, you're just taking one for the team, are you? Do you have to be so obvious about it?
I'm not going
to
fall out with you, Trevor. Not now we have come so close to getting everything we ever wanted.
Well, what do you want?
You and the baby. We are going to be a proper family, and we're going to have Kim out of our lives forever. All we need to do is get through the next month or so.
No.
What do you mean, no?
I'm not doing it. I am not letting that mad bitch come between us anymore.
Trevor!
Look, I mean it. We get shot off Kim now, okay?
Grab you some pyjamas for tomorrow. You look like you need them.
You're lactating.
Listen, it's natural. Don't worry about it. It'll stop when, you know.
I hand him over to Grace. What if I don't want to, Kim?
But you promised.
I didn't think I'd feel like this. But as soon as I held him in my arms, everything changed. He's my son. Kim, I can't give him up.
Funny Friday, the three amigos. Actually, sombreros could work. The last leg. Who's the guest? Hang on. Amy Poehler? 10 o'clock. 11:05, Josh all alone. We plucked him from last leg, put him on stage and made him say hilarious things. Channel 4 News is coming next.
Yes, good night, girls, and thank you very much indeed. Good night.
Rainey. Rainey! Why isn't there any money in the till?
Is there not? Are you sure?
You've been handing out free drinks, haven't you?
I should probably go. Good night, my darling.